As with many of the features in our software, the report setup has multiple applications, one of which is to allow you to personalize your ZYTO report to reflect your organization's branding, to create ads for clinic specials, and even integrate with your referral program. It is important for your patients to experience consistency with your branding and messaging, from your business cards, to your website, to even your ZYTO reports. One option is to include a cover page with each report that is generated. You can see here the client's information, the clinic information, promotion for a special, and advertising about their referral program are all included. When personalizing, it is a good idea to take some time to consider your business strategy. It may also be helpful to ask yourself, what is the most important information I want my client to take away from their visit? For example, this clinic used a report to create a form that helps individuals make healthy lifestyle choices, make recommendations, and even lays out a plan to do so. Another option is to include a coupon for your clients to share with their friends and family. When they show their report or progress, they can instantly refer them to your practice for some kind of complimentary service or scan. Again, personalizing should be based on your business's strategy and the way you have chosen to implement ZYTO into your practice. The goal is for your clients and patients to leave with your clinic report, not necessarily a ZYTO report. Let me show you how this is done. Navigate to the main screen, select Report Setup. The Report Setup view displays to the right, and you'll see a number of buttons and options. The New Report Block button allows you to create a report block from scratch. Think of these as building blocks to personalizing your reports. Report blocks can be placed throughout the report, not just on the front page. If you click Select Report Block from the drop-down menu, a list appears with several templates to choose from and which library they are located in. These templates can be used as is or as a great place to start when personalizing your own report. By checking Cover Page, you are telling the software to use the currently selected report block displayed below as your default cover page. So unless you are running a biosurvey and the original report author has restricted this, no matter what report is generated, this will automatically be the first page. This box is meant to save you time so that you don't have to go in and individually include the cover page after a report has been generated. The Edit, Copy, and Delete buttons are fairly self-explanatory and will only affect the report block you currently have selected. Next is the Adobe Acrobat toolbar that enables the reports to be viewable and interactive in PDF format. And finally, the preview area, where what you see is what you get. Displaying in this manner is a quick way for you to preview your report blocks and determine if you'd like to make any further changes. Currently, I have the default cover page selected from the drop-down list, and therefore the client's name, session date, return session date, and time will appear on my reports. Now that you're familiar with the report setup view, let's quickly create a new cover page. Here's a quick look at a finished design. I will be including a custom graphic for my reports with the ZYTO logo, some basic contact information, as well as the client's name. Now click on New Report Block. This is where we will be doing the bulk of our work. The first step is to give your report block a name. You'll notice that you are required to name a report block in order for it to be saved, thus activating the Save button. Next, select a report block from the options below. Again, think of these as building blocks that stack together to create your finished layout. You may want to take some time to see what each of these do and how they look. This can help you pick the user block that will best accommodate the information you're going to include. We'll select the text over banner option. Either double click or drag and drop the block into the report items column to begin editing. This column is where you organize the report blocks. You can add multiple report blocks here and rearrange them by selecting and dragging them in the order which you prefer. You can delete a report block by first selecting it and then hitting the delete key on your keyboard. The item properties column is where you can access the customizable properties for each particular report block. By typing a header into the header text area, your software will generate this text on the top of a thin gray bar that acts as a separator between the report blocks like this. It is worth noting that the header text will always display as Arial 9-point font. This is a default setting in the software and cannot be changed. Keep that in mind when using this feature. However, there are other options to customize this header, and you will find them here. For now, let's leave this alone and focus on adding an image. Simply click on Set Image, and from the drop-down choose Select New Image. This opens up your operating system's file browser and allows you to select an image you want to import from a folder on your computer. Select the image file and either double-click it or click Open. Once you've chosen your image, you'll notice the small thumbnail preview is now available along with some basic file information. Additionally, in the drop-down, you can see that I can clear the image I have currently selected by clicking on Clear Image. Or I can restrict my search to just ZYTO libraries. Maybe I want to go into ZYTO's main library and select an image of a heart. I simply find the image, double-click on it. Again, this report block is meant to be a header with my clinic branding for all of my reports. So I'll go ahead and clear this image and browse again for my banner graphic. Double-click it, and here it is. If you are working with an image of a very high quality or a large format, they will automatically be scaled down to fit the width of the page while maintaining their original aspect ratio. This means the image will not be distorted, only resized to fit the page. This also helps to reduce the file size so that the new image, when they're loaded into your library, aren't too large. Now that I have my banner in place, I want to add some text that sits on top of the image on the right-hand side. To do this, I can quickly use the text editor to type. Add basic styles, set the justification, and select the color that will show up best when sitting on top of my image. You also have the option to add custom information to each individual report without having to do this manually on a one-by-one basis. It's done by adding what is known as a tag, and is a small piece of code that instructs the software to go get and include specific information. For example, I'd like to be able to include each patient's name on their report without having to write or type it in by myself. To do this, I simply click on Add Tag and select from the drop-down list Client Name. You can see that the client's name will now appear below my clinic information. There are quite a few options you can choose from when adding tags. You may want to refer to the list as you plan how you will personalize your reports. Let's go ahead and preview our work to this point. By clicking Save, you will return to the report setup view, and there it is. Your first personalized report block. Now, if you notice that something needs to be changed or replaced, simply click Edit and make any further changes. Click Save and review and repeat until you are satisfied. With this new report block selected, I'll check the cover page box to make it appear as the first page on all of my reports. Sometimes it can be helpful to learn from others' examples and save time by using parts you like and customizing others. Let's quickly review how this can be done by using the report block template. You'll remember that we can find the templates in the Select Report Block drop-down list. Click on one to preview it. When you find one you like, click on the Copy button, and it will take you directly into the editing view. First, name your new report block. I'll call mine Winter Specials. Now, making sure the first report block in the Report Items column is highlighted, I will set a different image. Again, I'll use my clinic banner. You'll notice when I selected the second report block, I have some new options over the Item Properties column. I'll leave this one as is and go on to the third report block to change the image. Now, in the last report block, I'll paste some info describing my winter specials from colds and flus, sore throats, and family packages of chiropractic treatments. I'll change this image. And now I'm ready to preview my changes. So this looks good. I'll check the report cover box again so that I can use this as the front page of my reports to advertise with for the next several months. When the promotional season is over and I want to change back to my standard report header, I'll click Select Report Blocks, choose it from the drop-down list, and make sure that the report cover box is checked. As I mentioned before, personalizing your reports can be applied in many ways and is a powerful tool to include in your clinic strategy. When used with a little thought and planning, it can make the difference in successfully implementing ZYTO into your practice.